Alright, I'm back, and I did promise one more challenge, and it is another one that is gonna use those quads, but it's also a skating position. Okay, so I'm kind of linking them and going with it, but it's quite a cool thing to be able to do. I'm gonna give you two versions of it. So we're gonna work towards a teapot, which is a pretty cool trick, and eventually leads into things like sit bones. Okay, and it's just a cool position, and just it's Friday, so something fun. Okay, so just to demonstrate, okay, we're gonna bring the leg up in front. So basically, it's what they would call a gun squat or a pistol squat, I can't remember the exact term. Okay, so we go out, leg extends in front of us, arms are forward, knee tracks completely over toe. I should have said that in the other video as well, actually. There we go, and we stretch, and we're gonna try to go to 90 degrees. Before we get to that stage, just to start it off, we're just gonna practice bending our knees, tucking our bum, sticking our bum out, and then tucking it behind us. So we can hug our knees, and we've got that very deep sit back there. Okay, so we're being nice and flexible. We can put our head on our knees, roll over. That feels quite nice as well. But we're practicing pushing that booty, that bottom underneath us, and then up through our squat that we've just been practicing. Okay, and then we go down. And again, we'll go just to 90 here, so we can sit there, strengthen it, and then tuck under, tuck our bottom underneath us, focusing on that really deep set knee bend. Now, a full teapot hydroglide would be at that kind of position, but if we can just get to 90, it's a start. And in terms of working things like sit spins, we only actually particularly want 90 because we tend to lose control when we go beyond that. Okay, so 90 is great. Eventually you'll get beyond it, but it's all in the strength as well as the flexibility. So, okay, but if we're just doing this for a bit of fun and to be able to do a teapot, because it's a cool trick to show off. Okay, leg forward and lift up. So we're engaging with turning that foot slightly, pointing the toe, engaging the quad, lengthening through the calf, lengthening the hamstring, arms up in front of us, shoulders and hips level, bending the knee, straight down. So we're really tracking directly down. We're not going to let that wobble or flop to the side. Strong abdominals, and we go down, and we can reach there and point. We can do cool things like lift it up if we want to, turn it out, bring it in. There's some variation sits, but let's just get to here first, and then see if we can recover on one foot. You may have to put it down to help you out. But if you can, it's really good to do that pistol squat, the gun squat, aka a teapot, and come up on the one foot. In front, extend, would help if I don't move the mat. Be strong, knee over toe, all the way down, sit at that 90. You can sit back into it once you're comfy, but keeping the core strong, lifting up, tucking in. Whoa. It's not such a strong side for me. So actually it should be there, down, and we can move through it and recover. And it doesn't matter if you're not quite there. So to recap, firstly practicing the squat, bringing the feet under, tucking under, giving yourself a hug, and then working up to extending out, down, 90 degrees, and then beyond, and then up. And that's a teapot. Well done. Have a great weekend, everyone. Bye-bye.